ठीक हो गया, थैंक यू वेरी मच। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ कामरान मीर एंड आई एम योर ई ट्यूटर फॉर दिस कोर्स विच इज़ बेसिक्स ऑफ ICT 5403। सो आई विल स्टार्ट विथ माय ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन। माय नेम इज़ कामरान मीर एंड आई एम वर्किंग इन अलामा इकबाल ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी एज एन असिस्टेंट डायरेक्टर IT इन इट्स ICT डिपार्टमेंट। एंड एज फार एज माई एजुकेशनल बैकग्राउंड इज़ कंसर्न, आई एम डूइंग माई PhD इन कंप्यूटर साइंसेज and previously I have done my master's in computer science and one master's in remote sensing and GIS from NUST. So overall my experience is all about programming and the computers, and now my research area is on educational technology. So this course is very brief, very basic course for you. If you have already done ICS or if you have ever studied computers basic course, so it will be no more like difficult for you to understand this basic course. But in this course we will try to understand the basic concept of ICT and we will try to relate it with our real life or real society problems. So this is the unit 1, which is talking about the introduction of information and communication technology. Okay, so in this unit you will learn about the introduction, you will get the introduction of the terminologies used in ICT or IT, and what is information, what is communication, what is technology, and what is the basic concept of ICT, and what is the role of ICT in society, and what are the ICT applications. And we will also talk about the computer and internet, cell phone and ICT in teaching and learning. So the objectives of this unit, the objectives are very important. I would like to discuss this point as well. What I feel as a teacher as well, or as a student, what thing is missing in Pakistan especially, we don't have our objectives. We should always have our objectives of our life, objectives of our doing anything. If you are studying, if you are doing any job, you should have your own objectives. You should not work, or you should not like start doing thing without keeping the objective in your mind. So if you don't have any objective, for example, you just sit in the bus, you just like start traveling anywhere, and if you don't have objective, you cannot go anywhere. Like if you want to go Lahore, so without knowing the bus routes, you cannot just sit on the bus and later you cannot think that you have to go to Lahore or Karachi. You understanding my point? Okay, so the basic objective of this unit is to understand the basic concept of ICT, to explore the role of ICT in society and identify the importance of ICT in society, explain and exemplify the applications of ICT, and to determine how ICT can be used as an aid to computer teaching as well as learning. So ICT is the abbreviation of information, communication and technology. So we will talk about first what is information and what is the communication and what is the technology. You might have heard the terminology IT. Previously, people used to call IT. Later on, the terminology changed or improved, and now people call it ICT, Information and Communication Technology. Why? I have also uploaded a lecture which was recorded last year in the LMS. I will also share the link here later. After the lecture, you can watch that video. So what is the information basically? So the information is the raw facts and figure. For example, you see anything, you write down anything, so everything is like raw data. So for example, you do a survey in your street and you collect the names of the people, their age, their gender, their qualification. So once you have collected all the data, so this is the data. Why it is data? Because you have not processed it. Once you have processed what I mean by processing, like once you write them down on a paper, on a piece of paper, and if you start counting them, how many number of people are there, you have recorded how many male, how many females, how many old age people, how many young people, how many like middle age people, how many people in your streets who have done masters, how many people who are below matric. So this is information. Once you have processed the data, which can tell you anything, which can tell you to make any decision. For example, if you want to give a laptop in your street to study, so this data can help you out to shortlist the people who are more suitable to be given the laptop. So this is information. How data converted to the information after we process the information, after we process the data, sorry, when we process the data, so it will become the information. All of you are hearing me. Is it okay to continue in English or we can do in Urdu as well? It's up to you. Previously, I was recording, I was doing my lecture in Urdu, but since I have traveled 5 countries and these days I was also applying for the PhD scholarships, so I think it is better to give education in English. It is the right time that we should start speaking in English, because at later stages most of our students, like they face a lot of problems while giving the interviews, while applying for the scholarships, while writing the applications, like scholarship applications. Okay, Ikra has responded. What about Arib and Sadia? Please give your input. You don't have to worry. It is completely fine with me. I can speak in Urdu, and I'm also learning English as well. So I thought it is a good option to speak English. We all can learn because it gives you confidence. At this stage, we are all learning. So when you go to the industry, so if you already know how to speak and you are like more familiar, so it will be more good for you people. Alright, that's fine. I will also share the links of my previous lectures which I've recorded. Those are in Urdu as well, so you can watch those lectures as well. I will also record these lectures and I will upload these lectures. You can also watch them later on as well. Alright. So the ICT is a combination of information. We have talked about the information, how data is converted into information. All right. Is there any highlighter? Let me see. All right. So now we will talk about the communication. Previously, all the computers were like they were standalone. Normally people were using desktop computers at home, so they were not communicating. So that's why the terminology was more related to the information technology only, and the communication technology was working separately. For example, the telephone network, and then the satellite communication. But now if you see, your mobile is a computer as well. Your mobile is a communication device as well. It is also storing the information, it is also communicating at the same time. So now all the devices, whether they are a laptop, whether they are a tablet, whether they are your smartphones, so now the things have moved. So both the technologies, information technology and the communication technologies, have been converged. They are like merged together. So that is why nowadays the more appropriate terminology is ICT, information and communication technology. All right, the technology means the recent or the modern way of doing anything. So this is the basic thing: information, storing of information, and communication. This is the very basic trait which all human beings do since they were like, since they came into, since their existence, they were storing the information and they were also communicating using the different methods. And by the time comes, what is the nature of the human that it improves themselves? The way how they were storing the information in very early ages, now the method has been changed. Similarly, the ways and methods which were being used to communicate, like they were communicating on the maybe rocks, maybe on the skin of the animals, and later on maybe on the paper. Now in like from past decade, now the paper environment is also like depreciated. Now paperless environment has arrived, and now you can communicate through technology using the electricity, maybe using telephone, using the satellite communication. So there is no paper now. So nowadays the communication method is electronically. So this page is all talking about the same thing, the information communication. We have already talked about the communication system in which internet, cell phone, telephone, television, radio. Alright. So this is the communication model which we were talking about. So the communication model, there is an aspect of radio, television, cell phone, internet and computer, standalone computer. So everything is like is connected with the communication model. Nowadays your computer can be connected to the internet, your internet can be connected to the cell phone, you can watch television, your televisions are also smart now, they can connect to the internet, your radio is also now online. So everything is a part of your communication model. So what is the technology? Technology is generally defined as making, modification, adaption and usage of tools, techniques, systems or machines. Similarly, I just talked about previously, technology is the method of doing things in a new way, like adopting new things. Take a techniques of and how to solve the problems is the technology. After having a brief concept of all these individually, ICT can be easily defined as, how we can define the ICT, it is any system, product or machine which can receive, store and transmit information or data electronically in a digital form. So you're getting my point? Any system or any device which can store, which can receive, store and transmit the data in electronic, like in zeros and ones, in binaries. So this, so any system or any product which can handle this, which can store the data in electronic form and also transmit the data, so we can call it an ICT thing. So what is the basic concept of ICT? So they have this figure can tell you a better thing. So ICT is a big umbrella, it's a big like ground in which everything is covered in ICT. You cannot only say that computer is ICT or laptop is ICT. So your radio, your television, satellite systems, internet, your cell phones, your computer and many more things. Even now the air conditioner. Can we consider air conditioner in ICT? Yes, please respond. Do you think can we consider the air conditioner in ICT? Anyone else, please? Who left? Arif? No, Arif has told Sadia and Arif. Ikra. Think about the recent one. The AC. Nowadays, AC can store the data as well and they can communicate as well. Have you heard about the terminology IoT? Internet of Things. So what is the Internet of Things? That things can communicate with each other. So nowadays your television, which is smart enough, your AC is no more like the conventional AC, it can also, it is a digital like device which can store the data, which can communicate with your mobile. So you can communicate with your AC using your mobile phone. Have you ever done this? Yes, you can put on and put off your AC from your mobile phone. You can develop an application, mobile application, which can communicate with your AC, even with your projectors. So all the electronic devices, even with your lights. So your lights can, in IoT, your lights can also be controlled, your gates can be controlled. So everything, so nowadays, so this umbrella is slightly older one. So now if you think about nowadays, so anything, think which is covered in the definition which we have discussed in previous slide. So anything or any system which is storing the information. Yes, that is great. If we can easily control AC with cell like device. So everything, your doors, your windows, your electric lights, electric bulbs, your projector, your air conditioner, if it is able to store the data, any kind of data, if it is able to store the data and it is able to communicate with other devices, so it means it will fall under the umbrella of information and communication technology. All right. So your vision should be broader enough. Oh, that's great. Okay, in internet, everyone knows the internet, you're using email, in social networking website, which is Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. Okay, do you know, in Pakistan, what is the, like, which social media platform is on number one? Which social platform is being used the most in Pakistan? Can anybody answer? WhatsApp, Instagram, yes, the Facebook is on the top. And but do you know what is, which social media platform is mostly used in China? I think the Facebook is the number one in Pakistan. Facebook and WhatsApp, Facebook is number one. Yes, but do you know sorry, do you know about, anybody knows about the China? So you know that the Chinese, they are number one in population. So they have billions, number one. So do you know what social media platform they are using? Because Google is blocked in China. And Facebook is also blocked in China. You cannot use Facebook in China. You cannot use WhatsApp in China. You cannot use Google in China. Okay, I will give you. Because China is not dependent on US, because these technologies which we are using in Pakistan, just like Facebook, WhatsApp, Google Maps, these are all US dependent. These are the US companies. So the China negate the US companies, they depend on their own, they are like independent, they don't depend even on the technology side as well. So in yes, they have their own sites. Let me list down, it will be good for your knowledge. In China, the one of the famous, very popular social media platform is just like the WhatsApp, it is WeChat. And just like the Facebook, they have QQ. So they're not using our systems. All right, we will discuss them later as well. So coming back to the topic, so this diagram will show you that ICT is very bigger picture under which the communication technology comes, and the other side was the information technology. Yes, we will also. In communication technology, which is talking about the communication, so it will cover the internet, it will cover the cell phone as well. So in internet you are using email, you are using social media platforms, and in cell phone you are calling, you're doing instant messaging. Now they are also being merged. This figure is also very like old, because now every cell phone is like connected with the internet as well. So now on your phones you are using all these things using a single platform. Using your mobile you can email, you can use social media platform, you can call, you can do messaging via your like operator, whether you want to do an instant message through the internet, it's up to you. So you can use both the platforms all in one. So things are being converged now. So what is the role of ICT in society? So what do you think, Adib, Ikra and Sadia? Is it the positive? Is it positive or negative? What is more? What is the role of ICT in our society? Is it positive or negative? What is the major one? Like, definitely there are both aspects of everything. Everything has a good aspect and bad aspect as well. But what do you think? What is the role of ICT in our society currently in Pakistan? Is it good or bad? Is it positive or negative? Good. Alright, overall is good. Yes, positive. We should think in a bigger picture, because if you see in all the fields, the ICT is playing a very good role. I think it's more on the lights. Oh, alright. Okay, it's your point of view as well. It is okay. Yeah, in some context there are some negative side as well. But if you see, if you think in a bigger perspective, for example, you can see the education system. In all the schools we are using the technology, or even not in the school, even in your social life you are using your mobile phones. Even your grandparents are using mobile phones, so they can communicate with your with all the families who are living abroad. So now they are like able to connect with them in seconds. In past it was not possible, so people are now aware enough. So through the social media, now news or any good information can be like transmitted anywhere, to anyone. And also the education perspective has been changed. Just like we are now having a teaching and learning process, you are learning like sitting at your homes, and we are like using technology to communicate. Even if you see in a more bigger perspective, all your banking systems have been changed. You know, you can use mobile banking, you can transfer anywhere, and you can in business. In previously you have to maintain all the records on paper. Now using the softwares, it has improved the business processes, it has reduced the cost of human. Just like the aeroplane is also technology. So before aeroplane, it was very difficult to travel like far off places. So there are more, I think, to in my point of view, there are more good things overall. If you think about the overall the world situation, the human have like they have achieved more things using the technology. So I'm not negating the negative side, because there are also many negative things, especially in developing countries like Pakistan. Definitely there are more negative things than the developed countries. It is because we are not like aware, or we are not mature enough. It is similar just like if you give a smartphone having an internet to a young child. Yes, it is playing very good role. So if you think the negative role can be understood very in a good way, just think of a small child. If you have your brother or small younger brother or sister, if he is like 5 years old or maybe 4 years old, and you give him a smartphone which has all the latest things. It has the YouTube, it has the internet, everything on. So when you give so much exposure to the young child, so it will create a negative things, definitely, because he is not mature enough. He don't know what is good or what is bad. So same is the case for our society as well. So as a whole, our society is not mature enough. Yes, our society is not mature enough, because as a whole, if you see, we have like 50%, more than 50% population, they are illiterate. So they don't know how to write their names even. And more than 50% people are not having a food of one time. So our literacy rate, our poverty rate, everything is so down. So if we consider our whole society, so they are not up to the mark. So they are not mature enough, just like a kid who is not aware of what is good or what is bad. So that definitely, this is the one of the reason when you give the technology to those who are not aware enough, so that they will definitely misuse it. There are the more chances that it is being misused. So it is our role, like it is the main responsibility of our youth, just like you and me. It is our responsibility to use, underdeveloped country. So it is the responsibility of our government and our youth, educated youth, especially, just like you are the educated youth, teachers, students, we are more responsible and our government is more responsible. We should aware the people or in our circle so that we can use, so we can improve or increase the positive usage of the technology. So what are the ICT applications? The ICT applications enable people to communicate with each other in real time all the world. The detail of some of the most important example of ICT applications are described below. Computer and internet. Okay, just like so these are some of the advantages or the applications, like we are doing online selling and purchasing. Can you name any site through which we can sell and purchase? We can do the online purchasing and selling. Yes, OLX. What else? Daraz. Yes. And similarly, there are many sorts of entertainment. You can watch movies, music, everything. Now you don't have to purchase the like cassettes. You can just watch them online. Similarly, you can buy the softwares. You can download the software, then download anything. Document sharing. You can just share the things, just like you are watching my screen or a document which was placed in my computer, and now you are watching. So there are many ways to share information on the internet. Searching through various search engines like Google, you can search anything, any question. You can communicate with the other peoples using different softwares, like through email, through Skype, through social networking websites, just like we are doing through Big Blue Button, or we can communicate through WhatsApp or all the platforms. So other aspect is the cell phone. We have already talked about this. So now there's not much difference between the cell phone or the computer. Now your smartphones are basically other computers. So anything which you can do on your laptop is equally possible on your mobile phone as well. So everything is possible using mobile phone. Am I right? Yes. Everyone, all of you are having a smartphone. Yes. So now there is no much difference between if you talk about the computer or a mobile phone. So everything is possible, because on mobile is you're just like a computer. Everything you can do. In fact, from laptop or from computer, maybe you cannot communicate. You cannot call, like you don't have SIM. But some of the laptops also have the facility of SIM, just like your tablets. So how we can use the ICT in teaching and learning? I think this is the most which you know, you are already practicing it. Just like we are right now, our class is the perfect example of using ICT in teaching and learning. We are communicating with each other. We don't have to like to be in a class. We are sitting on our own places, in our own places, and we are communicating using the technology. So even in the classroom, your projectors, your screen projectors can also be called a use of ICT. Even if in the classroom if we use the mobile phone to conduct the quizzes, and if we use a computer lab to give examples, we can use any other technology things. And in the classroom or even either if you're sitting at the home, just like using internet. So all these are covered. These are the ICT in teaching and learning. So what is the purpose of ICT? What do you think? We should know the objective. So what is the objective of ICT? Why we are using ICT? Please answer me in comments. Why we are using ICT? Why we want to use ICT? Like, is it mandatory to use ICT? What if we don't use ICT? I think because there are, if in Pakistan, most of the people see there are so many problems, there are negative aspects of ICT. So why we are using ICT? Yes, to communicate easily, to save the time, because if you see my lecture, which I've already shared on the LMS, I will also share the link here in chat as well. There I've mentioned, because it is in human nature. It is the human nature to improve. If you just see, if you compare the human with other creatures, just compare them. If you see a lion, do you think lion, they have changed their way of living? Have they changed their way of hunting? Have they changed their way of communicating? Think about the sparrows. Think about the birds. Have they changed their way of living? Have they changed their way of communicating? Think about other creatures. How they were like living, how they were communicating, how they were eating 1,000 years back? Please answer, please communicate. Yes, it is the nature of human experience. Yes. If you compare the human with other creatures, so they don't change. Just like sparrows, just like birds, animals, even if you go 1,000 years back, so they were eating, they were communicating, they were like living, just like they are living right now. But if you see the nature of human being, humans are also communicating, humans are also living, humans are also like communicating with each other, they are living, but their way of living, their way of eating, their way of communicating, all their ways have been improved. So it is in their nature, every next day, like humans think of more better way. They think how better they can like live. Before they were living in mountains, later on they were living in mud house, later on they started living in cemented house, and now you can see they are living in tall buildings. Similarly, how they were communicating, their ways of communicating have emerged, new languages came in, new standards of languages started coming. Similarly, how they started communicating, they were communicating through through symbols, then the language came, they were communicating through on papers, then on telephones, then internet. So if you see all the things, it is in the, letter is the first way of communication, but nowadays ICT makes it easy to, yes. So the every other day, what we conclude from this comparison of human being and other creatures, so that's why humans are on the top, the humans are selected one, the God has, like, they are the leaders. That's why they, because they have the sense of development. They develop, so they don't work for, they don't work for their own, they work for everyone. Definitely, when humans develop any technology, so it is not the property of one person. So that technology or that thing is being used by all other humans or even all other creatures. So this is the main difference of human being and other. So this is the question of answer to the question why we are using ICT. So this, the purpose of ICT is to improve the things. So the purpose of ICT in teaching and learning becomes to teach well, to learn well, and to present well in best time, like without like wasting time, without wasting resources, to get maximum with losing minimum, to work efficiently, to share ideas easily, to solve the different problems easily, to gain precise knowledge, and to achieve the goal in less time period. So now the use of ICT is also increasing in educational areas. This theme gives young generation many ways of learning as well as generating new ideas. So this facility in classroom can prove to be very helpful for teachers to teach and for the learners to learn. So this was all about today's lecture. So what are the self-assessment questions? So you have to write down the advantages and disadvantages of ICT. We have already discussed. So advantages are like we can communicate in less time without wasting so many resources and so many things in banking sector, in education sector, in your personal life, in your business, everything, in every domain, there are so many advantages of ICT. And in disadvantages also, if you don't regulate the use, if you don't make the awareness, so the same can be very negatively used as well. Just hold a second, please.
You are now muted. You are now unmuted.
Because ICT is just like a tool. For example, the knife. The knife is also a tool. Because the same knife, there are advantages. You can cut meat, you can cut the fruits, you can cut many things to eat, or you can even cut many things to make different things. But the same, if you don't give the awareness, if you don't give the knowledge of good and bad, the same knife can be used for killing the people. The same knife can be used to harm the people. The same knife can be used for doing the wrong things. In same case, explain the role of ICT in teaching and as well as learning. We have already discussed this thing. Explore the importance of ICT in different fields like education, business, and training. Explain in detail with the help of examples. You can, I think, write down what is email and what are the social networking websites. We have already discussed this. Explain the difference between ICT and telecommunication. We have also discussed this. ICT is more about IT, like information, and telecommunication is more about the communication, like mobile phone, like telecommunication, internet. Why internet and cell phones are being considered the best examples of ICT. So now you can also better explain, because cell phone and internet nowadays, it is more best example of ICT because it has like it is covering all the aspects. In mobile phone is more like appropriate, it is covering more all aspects of the technology. Understand what ICT is and give examples of practical applications to society. I think you can also write down under this question. Internet is well known example of ICT, how it enables people. You can also write down about this question. To communicate easily through different communication. Okay. What are the self-assessment activities? Write, create an email account. I think all of you have email account. So what I will give you the assessment activity. You must create an email account of your family member if they don't have. I think your like mother or father or any old person, your like grandmother or any one of any your grandparent most of like them, some of them may don't have the email address, so you have to create an email address for them. Is it okay? Will you create email address? Do they have? Okay, yeah, okay. Okay, how software and documents can be downloaded through internet? I think you have already done most of the people like download music and movies as well. So you can also download the softwares. We will also discuss the types of software in later lectures. So, like which softwares are like should be downloaded or not? Is it ethical to download the software or not? Okay, how can we share documents with each other through internet? Definitely through email, through Google Docs, different sharing softwares, online platforms. How people can communicate through social networking websites. I think you know this better. How the internet will be used in mobile phone. I think